Hi, this is Jimmy Weezer, the fictional character that somewhat exists. I'm just filling you in, updating you on my 10-day fast. The reason I didn't do day 9 and day 10 after day 8 is it was the weekend. I was feeling kind of lazy. Plus, I'm just an inconsistent kind of person. Anyway, I just wanted to fill you in. The downside, I will say the last two nights, the last 2 days, something interesting. And I heard some other people say they experienced it too, but my stomach started getting into a frenzy, gurgling. I could feel the extra acid and my mouth started salivating like crazy and with like a weird taste in my mouth, like a kind of sweet fruity taste. The most annoying part was that taste. It was really, really annoying. And so when it came down to the final day, I was definitely ready to eat to get that taste out of my mouth. That literally was the biggest reason why I was ready to end the fast. But overall, it was a great experience. When you get in that I would say that middle section of the fast where the initial pains are gone and you feel kind of a tranquil feeling in your head, and you feel relaxed. That's really a special moment, something very unique. I don't think anything else has ever made me feel exactly the way that made me feel. But anyway, overall, I would say it was definitely a wonderful success. But it was time to get back to eating. A lot of people will tell you what you should eat to get back in, out of a fast. A lot of people even like, I guess, sort of fear monger, like basically, you know, if you eat solid food, you're gonna die or, you know, something like that. I've researched people's personal experiences and I've noticed a few people that tried to follow the suggestion to have juicier, watery fruits. Like one guy, he ate watermelon after the fast, and what he described, the results, the side effects after eating, it pretty much was the same that I experienced eating solid food. And so that just kind of makes me feel that no matter what you eat, your body has to readjust. It has to do whatever it needs to do to get back to normal. And what does that really consist of? Well, many people can tell you, evacuation. It's almost like the food comes in and your body recognizes that it needs to flush out the system. You can kind of think about like if you're in a home that the pipes haven't been running for a while and, you know, you got to flush them out, all the guck and stuff out of the pipes to make way for the clear, clean water, I guess you could say. So I think that's just your body's natural response. Now, so basically, out your backside comes a lot of liquid for a bit. And depending on who you are, this might be, you know, disgusting or might be kind of cool, you know. But one thing it isn't, it wasn't that like horrible, deathly painful experience that some people will try to make it out to be. I would say you probably want to keep it simple though. You don't want to overeat on your first meal. That's probably the most important thing. And because of all that flushing out, you'll probably want to drink more water, make sure you stay hydrated. But overall, I mean, I basically had a decent amount of grilled chicken, and also my wife had some boiled yuca. I don't know, if you're not Hispanic, you might not know what that is, but it's basically kind of like a root vegetable, like potato-ish. But I had a nice piece of boiled yuca after all the chicken, and that's all I really had to break the fast. And so everything's been going great. I got back to work today, had decent energy. So the game plan going forward is to avoid the things that make me sick, number one. Avoid the grains, avoid things that are overly sugary, I guess you could say. And so far that's what I've basically had is meat, a little bit of not full dairy, but cheeses. Cheese doesn't never has bothered me. And a little bit of vegetable. That's what I've had so far. I'll probably expand to having something like potatoes or like I said, yuca, other root vegetables, other complex carbs like that. But definitely number one, I don't want the grain. I want to hate the grain. Yuck, yuck, grain. Blech! Let's hope that stays consistent. So far everything's gone well, and in the end, even a couple of days after I started refeeding, I hadn't gained any weight back. I'm 23 pounds down. I went from 236.5 pounds down to 213 and a half. And that's stayed good. And that's what I want to do. I don't want to. Now, I mean, it might be inevitable to gain a few little extra pounds because your body is just constantly, going to have the food to digest in it. I don't know. Whatever the case, I'm trying not to regain, trying to stay consistent, not overdoing it right now. So that's enough blabbing. It's almost up to 7 minutes. But anyone that's been following these and cares, or at least pretended to care, gave a thumbs up, gave a comment, appreciate you. And I hope I don't let anybody down. I'll fill you in probably on progress on just how I've been staying healthy if you want, whoever you are, or if I'm talking to nobody. Anyway, have a good day.